What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you a new real-time render and virtual reality software called Eyecad VR. Let's get started. Eyecad VR is a software where you can import your 3D models and quickly create real-time renders as well as virtual reality tools. You can download a free trial by going to eyecadvr.com. After you have signed up, you can download the program and run the installation. When you have installed the program, you will see this window. There are two options, Designer and Explorer. We will start with the Designer option because we want to import a 3D model. Here, you can log in with your email and license key that they provided after the signup. After you log in, click here to download the latest update. When it's done, click this button again to launch it. When you first open Eyecad VR, you will see a window that lists recent projects. In this case, we will be creating a new project. There are also demo projects that you can explore here. When creating a new project, you can give it a name and specify a folder location. After a project is created, you can see that Eyecad VR has a really nice and simple user interface. Down here are the different sections that you can use to modify your scene. I will cover these later. Now I will import a 3D model by clicking on the Eyecad VR logo and select Import 3D Model. Eyecad VR supports many types of 3D files, but in this case, I will use my SketchUp model. Another way to import a SketchUp model is by using the Eyecad VR SketchUp plugin. You can download it from the extension warehouse and then install it using the extension manager. Before I import my SketchUp model into Eyecad VR, I need to do two things. The first thing to do is to make sure that my model does not have more than 150 materials, because exceeding this limit might result in an error in Eyecad VR. You can go here to see your model info, and go to this section to see how many materials are in your model. If there are unused materials in your model, then you can use the Purge Unused feature to remove materials that are not in use. The second thing I need to do is to make sure my geometries are facing the correct direction. When I use the monochrome style, I will be able to see which geometry is facing the wrong direction. By default, the front face in SketchUp is white and the back face is blue, so you can see that this object has reverse faces. To fix it, I can just select those faces and right-click Reverse Faces. Now I can save the model and click this button to import it into Eyecad VR. Then a dialog box will open in Eyecad VR. I'll leave these at the default settings and just change the use software to SketchUp and import it. It will take a while to import your model depending on how large it is. After it is imported, you can see the model here in the personal object section. To navigate in Eyecad VR, you can use the right mouse button to look around. While holding down the right mouse button, use WASD to move. You can also use Q to move down and use E to move up. Holding Shift will allow you to move faster. Using the middle mouse button will let you zoom and pan. To select an object, use the left mouse button. There we go. Now let's start setting up our scene. First, I will go to the Environment tab to adjust the lighting of the scene by changing the time, date, location, and orientation. I can also change the cloudiness using the slider here. The Weather tab will let you change between the sunny, rainy, and snowy weather. I will cover this in more details later. Finally, you can turn on HDRI here. Eyecad VR comes with a selection of really good HDRIs. Each of them has two options, one with the sky on and one with the sky off. The option with the sky off will allow you to use the background of the HDRI while using the dynamic sky and clouds of Eyecad VR. You can also import a custom HDRI using this button here. When using HDRI, you can adjust the brightness and rotation using these sliders here. There we go. Now you can use these options to set up the perfect ambience for your scene. Next is lighting. For this model, I will only use the area light. After I have added the light, I can use the Modify tab to move, rotate, and scale the light to fit my model. I can press W for the Move and Rotate tool, then use the Gizmo to position the light. You can also enter a specific value here if you want to be more accurate. Then I can press E for the Scale tool and size it to make it fit the scene. It's important to place the light on the inside of the doors and window, shining toward the room. When adding the light, you can also hold Shift to activate Angle Snap to make it easier to rotate the light accurately. As you can see, the area light is a great way to enhance the sunlight and make the scene more realistic. Next, I'm going to go to the Effects tab and add a reflection probe by dragging it in like so. This is a good way to increase the quality of reflection on materials. Now I need to place it in the middle and size it to fit the room. To make it easier, I can use the view cube and turn off perspective mode. It's important to make the external area of the reflection probe touch the walls, ceilings, and floors, but do not go over them too much. Stay inside the walls when you do this. I'm going to edit the glass material so you can see the reflection easier. As you can see, the reflection probe makes your material have better reflection, making it more realistic. Once finished, I can go to Settings and hide the reflection probe with this option here. And I can hide the area light as well. You can see that the area light and reflection probe still work even though we hit them. Next is editing materials. When importing a model into Eyecad VR, all of your materials will be located in the Materials tab in the Personal Materials section. You can click on a material to see its settings. By default, Eyecad VR will automatically convert materials to PBR materials by giving texture materials normal and reflection maps. This will help your materials editing process a lot easier. If you want to edit a material more, then you can easily adjust it using these sliders here. Remember to save the material after editing, otherwise it will reset to its default. Instead of finding the material in the list, you can also select an object and right-click Edit Materials. There we go. Just use these workflows to edit the materials in your model. You can also create a material from scratch by clicking here. Then import a custom texture here. And now you can use it in your model. Eyecad VR also comes with a huge library of materials that you can use. These are web-based, so you can download whichever you want. After it's done downloading, it will be under Personal Materials. And now you can drag it on an object to apply it. Here you can see an object that has reverse faces, which we forgot to fix in SketchUp. We can fix it here in Eyecad VR by selecting the object, right-click, Mesh Settings, Reverse Faces. For materials like leaves that only has one surface, reversing it doesn't fix it. So you can edit the material and turn on the two-sided mode. That's better. Eyecad VR also has a library of objects in different categories such as bathroom, decorations, table and chairs, etc. You can use these to populate your model very quickly and easily. When you're done editing materials and adding objects, you can go to the Settings tab to make some changes to your image, such as adjusting the quality and resolution, saturation, contrast, brightness, adding bloom effect, etc. When adjusting brightness, if the HDRI gets too bright, then go back to the Environment tab and adjust the power to make it look better. When you're ready to render, click the camera button to create a view. Here you can position the camera. You can also adjust the camera settings such as field of view and focusing distance, which controls the depth of field. Once the camera is created, the position will be locked. If you need to change it, then you need to unlock the camera. There are also built-in filters, which can be used to stylize your render. Then you can control the strength of it using the filter intensity slider. If you go to the Modify tab, you can adjust the camera position more accurately. There you go. Now you can create more views by clicking on the camera icon and use the same workflow to adjust your render. You can use the arrows to move between the views as well. Once you're happy with what you have, you can choose a resolution, a folder, and a name. Then you can click here to render. And those are the tips for using Eyecad VR. There are also other cool features like landscaping and VR tours, but I will cover these topics later. And that is all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, comment below and let me know what you think of your software. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.